through the eyes of a Jewish mystic. Rabbi Avraham, Tzvi, Kook, Lights of Holiness. He wrote the following. He said, the mystical quest penetrates to the depth of all thought, all feelings, all tendencies, all aspirations, in all worlds from beginning to end. Everything is important. There is no lost gesture. All is interdependent, organically related. The mystical vision is the soul of religion, of Torah. Its far-reaching unity embraces all creatures, all expressions of life, all objectives and ideals. Let's explore four dimensions that a true Kabbalist, the real one and the one inside of yourself, sees and experiences constantly. First dimension, the infinite dimension. The Creator is infinite. The Creator's whole design of the creation was to hide His infinity from us until we could discover how to reveal once again all that is, that all is infinity. Essential points of all Kabbalistic teachings is to re-infinitize the finite. Therefore, the goal of the Tzimtzum creation process of contracting God's infinite presence to allow for a creation to exist is to ultimately re-infinitize everything. The goal of the light vessel evolution process, seeking the maximal synchronization between the lights and the vessels that contain them, is to produce a setup of vessels that can contain infinity. The commandments, according to Kabbalistic consciousness perspective, is to infinitize and therefore liberate the actions of reality that we take or do. The goal of mystical consciousness is to infinitize and thus liberate thought. The goal of Ratzon, the Kabbalistic state of fusing our will with Hashem's will, is to infinitize and thus liberate our will and our calling in life and our capacities to be the right arm extensions of God's Tikkun Olam process. Divine bridge traits referred to as the Sefirot are to infinitize all processes and all structures, including those of our own persona. The goal of the tikkun, the rectification of cosmic brokenness, is to transform reality into a conduit and conductor and environment for infinity. Upper and lower world interpersonal relationships is to tap into each other's infinite wellsprings and thereby unify with each other and thereby reproduce infinite shefa or abundance for all of the world to be nurtured from. With the infinite. This is the root of every wanting. No other object, idea, or love can satisfy its desire. It's not only what the soul wants, but what all of existence wants. Humanity's goal of returning to the Garden of Eden, its paradise state, as well as the messianic state, is to arrive at a consciousness and a reality where all that which was lacking will be complete, and all of that which was finite will be infinite. The wisdom of the hidden or unseen. See the vastness of what there is to see that are normally not seen. See the vastness of the normally overlooked gifts that people give you. Accessible to you that you normally overlook. See the vastness of coping tools that you constantly create. See the vastness of salvations that Hashem sends you all the time. See the vastness of guidance that God constantly sends to you. See the vastness of love that you have in your heart, usually unexpressed. See the vastness of experiences and life lessons that you have experienced.
Yo, 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 yo
Kabbalah is referred to as the wisdom of correspondences, all correspondence to all else so profoundly that everything comes together in a profound state of unity. Number one, see how all is interincluded. See how everything is interincluded in everything else. What's outside of you is also inside of you. What is needed to realize this is to plug in and feel and resonate and recall. Try to feel and resonate inside of yourself with things that are outside of yourself. Whether they be outside of yourself in space or in time. Keep on pushing buttons of resonation until you can truly identify that which is outside of yourself, inside of yourself. Until you can feel what a person, a place, a historical happening feels like. Everything is dependent on everything else. How actions are dependent on words. And how words are dependent on feelings. And how feelings are dependent on thoughts. And how thoughts are dependent on will. And how will is dependent on God's will. See how one person's will, thoughts, feelings, actions, and words are dependent on other people's same faculties, and others on them, and many people's on one central person. And this one central person's faculties is dependent on their teachers and their parents. And their teachers, teachers, and parents, parents, faculties going back and back to the beginning. See how the animal and plant and mineral kingdoms are dependent upon each other. See how large parts of the world's people are dependent upon a small part. See how large parts of history are dependent on one specific part. See how all of these independent entities are all significant, are all necessary parts of the whole. Number three, see how all is significant. See how the inter-inclusion and the interdependency of all things makes everything significant. Because everything in its own way and time and place is absolutely necessary for the needs of everything else. The body is significant for the soul. The physical is significant for the spiritual. The small is significant for the big. The dark for the light. Etc., etc. All is important. All is valuable. All is complementary to everything else. Number four, see the ramifications of this unity. See what is learned from this mystical unity, this inter-included, interdependent unity. See how this unity penetrates to the depths of all dimensions, all thought, all aspirations, all perfection. For when everything fits in, when everything harmonizes, when there is a special place reserved for all things, then there is peace, then there is oneness, then there is goodness, then there is clarity, then there is meaning, and there's a soul of reality which is revealed and controlled, and then everyone will know and see with the supernal hidden light of all, that everything is one and that all is connected together and connected to the divine source of all life. Referred to as the wisdom of receiving, a received tradition dating back to Sinai, as well as a way of engaging reality through the power and openness of receptivity. Be open to receive the totality of life experiences that come your way now. Choose the positive, goodly, and godly choices in life. Be open to receive the wisdom to know how to select and redeem your lost soul's sparks. Be open to receive the discernment to focus on the essence of everything. Be open to receive the sensitivity to feel deeply what others are feeling and respond properly and lovingly. Be open to receive the knowledge needed to hear and act upon your soul's voice. Be open to receive the understanding that's required to see how the smoothness or lack of it in your life is directing you to what to rectify and how to rectify it. Be open to receive the foresight to guide others and yourself towards their life calling. Be open to receive the compassion needed to reach out and help heal other people. Be open to receive all the consciousness that's beyond your present level. Hey.